The history of money began with commodities. From the very beginning, there's always the need to exchange goods and services between people. This is how life works. So from commodity money, such as grains, sugar, salt, to precious metals like gold and silver, to their paper representations, to fiat currency, which is what we call cash today, to electronic cards, money has evolved through the years to the present digital age, and it is evolving yet again, this time from its very core. The technology is ripe for the reaping. Computers and smartphones are more than powerful enough, and the internet is reliable, getting astronomically faster with every generation. All you needed was the right time for society to embrace the next evolution of money. And that time came in 2008 with the global financial crisis, which led to massive fallout in the global economy, including the Nigerian banking system. Big banks went bankrupt, recession followed, and government went into bailout mode. It is at this precise time and in this context that an anonymous author by the name of Satoshi Nakamoto released a white paper titled Bitcoin, a peer-to-peer electronic cash system, detailing for the first time the concept and the implementation of blockchain and Bitcoin, the birthplace of all cryptocurrencies and subsequently central bank issued digital currencies. Capital B, Bitcoin, is the computer software that creates the global payment network using computers connected to the internet. Lowercase b, Bitcoins, are digital money created and stored on the network. It is open source, public, and permissionless, so anyone can join the network free of charge and use Bitcoins. The Bitcoin protocol is how devices on the network communicate. Peer-to-peer, no single computer controls the network. All Bitcoins created and owned are entries in one big ledger called the blockchain, and it is constantly updated and communicated to every computer on the network. All other cryptocurrencies are based on this model with little to no changes in most of them. You see, the key is the blockchain technology. It solves a key issue bedeviling digital currencies since the 1980s, the problem of double spending, which is the main reason a trusted third party is required to mediate, such as a bank, in payments. If you send Mr. A some money, it is this third party that will confirm that you have the required balance to send such money. So they keep a central ledger, which has everybody's money in it. You know the whole story. So trust is key. Blockchain replaces the trust-based model with cryptographic proof, making transactions faster, more secure, less costly, more efficient, and without the need for a middleman. Which brings us to central bank digital currencies, CBDCs. Similar to cryptos, they are payment networks built on the blockchain, popularly dubbed as decentralized or distributed ledger technology, DLT. But unlike cryptos, they are private and permissioned by a central authority, but not as a middleman, as a facilitator. This central authority starts up the network, provides access to members, and issues the currency into circulation. All members are known and properly identified. CBDCs are highly configurable and can be customized to the needs of the network owner. Enter eNaira, a CBDC owned and issued by the Central Bank of Nigeria, CBN, recognized as a legal tender to complement the existing channels of payment, cash, card, mobile, and USSD, etc. eNaira has been designed to be a non-interest-bearing digital asset with one-to-one compatibility with the physical paper Naira, with the following objectives: to improve the availability and usability of money down to the grassroots, to promote financial inclusion, to reduce the cost of processing payments transactions, to improve the efficiency of cross-border payments and diaspora remittances, to facilitate efficient revenue and tax collection, and to disburse welfare direct to citizens. See the eNaira as an addition to the payment ecosystem that leverages digital technology to achieve the said objectives. It's a critical national infrastructure that has a far-reaching influence on the daily lives of the citizens. It is built on the distributed ledger technology called Hyperledger Fabric, an open-source modular enterprise permission blockchain ledger technology, which most CBDCs around the world adopt. Architecturally, eNaira is a digital payment network where payment is carried out by the eNaira itself as a unit of measurement. One Naira equals to one eNaira. Among its members, it's a two-tiered network. CBN sits at the top tier, hosts the collation of all transactions, designs, mints, and issues the eNaira to the next tier, which are the financial institutions and payment service providers who host their own copy of the ledger, then distribute the eNaira to the consumers, individuals, merchants, service providers, and government organizations. This is as far as the supply goes. To receive, hold, and spend the eNaira, you need a wallet, an electronic wallet, which is basically an application you can download and install on your mobile device or computer. CBN released the eNaira Speed Wallet for this purpose, available on Google Play Store and Apple App Store. Once you download and install it, to register an account is a two-step process. First, you enter your phone number and set password. Then you enter your bank details as contained in the BVN database. First name, last name, email, state of origin, date of birth, account number, and BVN. Accept terms and conditions and continue. Then you get a confirmation email or SMS. Then you log in with your email and password. The Speed Wallet app is of two kinds. There is the individual wallet and the merchant wallet. The individual wallet has four different categories. Tier 0, for individuals without bank account and NIN. Minimum account opening requirement is phone number. Daily transaction limit is 20,000. Maximum cumulative daily balance is 120,000 Naira. Then Tier 1, for individuals without bank account but have NIN. Minimum requirements for opening account is phone number and NIN. Daily transaction limit is 50,000 Naira and maximum cumulative daily balance is 300,000 Naira. Tier 2, for individuals with bank account, minimal spending. Minimum account opening requirement is BVN. Daily transaction limit is 200,000. Maximum cumulative daily balance is 500,000 Naira. Then Tier 3, for individuals with bank account, regular spending. Minimum requirement for opening account is BVN. Daily transaction limit is 500,000. Cumulative daily balance is 5 million Naira. The Merchant Wallet app requires an invitation code from the bank for validation, then identification details, TIN number, email, password, business category, business name, then you submit. The financial institution verifies the application, wallet is created and activated. Daily transaction limit is 1 million Naira and maximum cumulative daily balance is unlimited. This forms the Tier 4 of the wallet category. Let's talk about applications and services that can run on a CBDC network like eNaira. By application and services, I mean stuff like e-commerce, buying of tickets, tax and revenue collection, driver's license registration and renewal, insurance, sales of fintech products, and whatnot. Now, because the eNaira is built on the Hyperledger fabric, running applications and services is as easy as adding one more member to the network or a smart contract, that's the application, on an existing one. This member, typically a server, will have its own wallet to receive and send money, will have its own local copy of the ledger, and run applications called smart contracts. These smart contracts execute the business logic as defined, designed, and implemented on the blockchain, which brings us to how businesses and service providers can key into the eNaira platform. You just need to come up with your use case, your business logic, and the smart contract will execute it on the blockchain. The smart contracts will be endorsed on the network by other members to ensure that it is doing what it said it's doing and can be implemented in the standard, well-known programming languages like Java, JavaScript, Python, and Go. So there aren't many technical barriers. Now, this is a new tech, so there are definitely risks and concerns. Many countries, including China, who are leading the CBDC frontier with the e-renminbi, are still in their early stages of trial. There is still a steep learning curve, and this presents a regulatory risk. To build a resilient payment system as envisioned, open and innovative regulation must be promoted to adapt and respond to the evolving landscape as the eNaira is adopted. At this current stage, CBN has minted about 500 million Naira worth of eNaira on the system. The wallet is released. Individuals and merchants are being onboarded as we speak. Already, there are issues around the onboarding process. The wallet had to be taken down and reworked. Now it is back on, and this is part of the risk. Now, as time goes on, there is a likelihood that some informal use cases can show up and propel the eNaira into high demand. thus making a difference in the value of the eNaira to the physical Naira, creating another black market issue of different rates. You already know this with the Naira to dollar exchange rate. This is a potential challenge already foreseen by the CBN and are planning an effective regulation to address it by providing clarity and guidance on roles and responsibilities. The risk of money laundering and financing of terror, AML/CFT. To this, the eNaira network is connected to the BVN and NIN identity frameworks and TIN system for the corporate as a basic security layer to identify users. Financial institutions and payment service providers through which users are onboarding already perform KYC using these identity frameworks for existing account holders and would have to do it as a prerequisite for new customers. Users of eNaira would also be concerned with privacy and data protection, because using eNaira means letting go of the anonymity that comes with cash transactions. But this is the whole point of an enterprise-based distributed ledger blockchain technology: to keep transactions safe and secure with cryptography against malicious attacks, while also allowing regulations to guard against illicit flow and use of funds in ways that are harmful to society. eNaira is built with consideration around privacy and data protection in line with the National Data Protection Regulation, NDPR. The mere presence of a distributed ledger technology, namely blockchain, in the financial space presents the risk of taking out the trusted third-party model, which is the backbone of the existing financial institutions and payment systems. The conversion of Naira to eNaira will definitely impact balance sheet and turn the industry on its head. CBN is aware of this risk and has restricted the eNaira payment system to micropayments. Limits have been placed on wallets to enforce this. The risk of further financial exclusion. eNaira, being a digital currency, requires devices with internet connection to function. Already, the larger part of the financially excluded are in the rural areas who are uneducated, lack exposure and access to internet services and smart devices. This presents the risk of further alienating an already excluded population. To this, CBN is exploring offline channels to enable those sections of the population to have access to the eNaira platform, first starting with awareness and sensitization campaigns. There are also operational risks in the day-to-day use, ranging from legal to intellectual property rights, impact on central banks' own internal organization and processes, dispute resolution, reliability and availability of the back-end IT infrastructure, policy, governance, outsourcing and third-party risks. These are all within the impact range of a new payment system like the eNaira. I'm sure all these are all under consideration and measures are put in place to mitigate them. The threat of cybersecurity breaches. Despite the fact that the underlying technology has a proven track record of resilience against many of the commonly known attacks, there have been several cases of attacks and exploitation that led to losses in billions of dollars in the cryptocurrency landscape. The threat is real. eNaira, being the first in Africa, puts the system in the spotlight, creating a potential for cybersecurity risk. To this, IT security governance measures are put in place to conduct routine assessments with a view to identify vulnerabilities and implement internal control measures to mitigate such risks. Measures like architectural risk analysis, security threat modeling of the design, data flow and integrations, and such. The law of diffusion of innovation, popularly dubbed as the technology adoption lifecycle, of any new technology comes with inherent unquantifiable reputational risk. There is always an acceptance hurdle at first. The law states that if you divide the users of any high-tech product like this, the whole population as 100%, it says that 2.5% are innovators that come up with the ideas and build the products in the first place. 13.5% are early adopters. They will be the first to try. They love to be the first to try because they see an advantage. They are visionaries. Now, this is where the risk is, the chasm between the early adopters and the early majority. It's a hole of no return. If it works and the early adopters like it, they will tell the early majority and the late majority. That's when the product goes mainstream to wide adoption. The laggards or the skeptics, the last 16%, will never use it even if it works, so leave those alone. CBN is collaborating with key industry players to market the eNaira to early adopters and ensure its success. Here is a full implementation roadmap as given by the CBN in four phases, from launch to a full-blown payment system. I believe that the success of the eNaira will be determined by a successful financial inclusion. Being a new tech, the youth demographic is the ideal target for its wide adoption into mainstream payment system. This is a key moment to be an industry player within the eNaira ecosystem. All that is required is a use case. The possibilities are endless. Hyperledger Fabric, the underlying technology on which the eNaira runs, it's a highly active, scalable enterprise blockchain system that supports a wide range of industry use cases, ranging from government to finance to supply chain logistics to healthcare and more. To join the network, it's as easy as running few commands on an in-house or a cloud server with the right permission from the network owner, CBN, downloading a copy of the ledger, deploying smart contracts to run the logic of your use case, and you're part of the system. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. If you have any questions, post them there. I will answer. It's your public tech advisor. Thank you for watching. Until the next one. Cheers.